Where did the camera go? Boy, it's been quite a morning. We've been moving cameras, been doing internet work that we had to, take care of a hack attack and a Trojan, and playing with all kinds of fun little things that, unfortunately, when you're internet-based, you have to deal with on a regular basis. So, praise the Lord. Finally, get a chance to sit down and relax, and take a moment, speak to, and listen to, and hear from God, and let Jesus soothe our souls, so to speak, with what He would have us to stop, to look, to listen, to maybe take a moment or two to be still before the Lord and enjoy what He would say as He strengthens us for today for the issues that we face along our way, which for me today has already begun to be humorous. The fruit of the Spirit is meekness. The meek shall increase their joy in the Lord, and the poor among men shall rejoice in the Holy One of Israel. Except you be converted and become as little children, you shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. As I move a plant. Whosoever therefore shall humble himself as his child, the same is greatest in the kingdom of heaven. The ornament of a meek and quiet spirit is in the sight of God of great price. Charity vaunts not itself, and it is not puffed up. Follow after meekness. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shears is dumb, so he opened not his mouth. Christ also suffered for us, leaving us an example that you should follow his steps, who did no sin, neither was guile found in his mouth, who, when he was reviled, reviled not again, but commended himself to him that judges righteously. When I read that part where he committed himself to him who judges righteously, that means he didn't defend himself. A lot of people like to try to make Jesus out to be some kind of like macho man, and that he's going to come, in righteous anger and just wipe and annihilate. And, one of the things that Jesus wanted to keep conveying to us and to portray to us is we are not about violence. We are not a violent people. God handles the violent part of the universe. God is not violent himself. That is things that are not in order, that are not working according to his spirit, which is peace. You see, God does not... He's not a God of chaos. He's not a God of wrath. He's not a God of these things that people portray him out to be at times. But rather, God wants us to become meek and lowly like he was. Because he says he left us an example with which we should follow. Jesus could have said, be undone. And boom, wiped out everything in the universe. And yet he committed himself to God, his Father, so that he wouldn't be the one making self-decisions like we do when we get mad or get angry or get violent or think we have to defend ourselves. But rather, he said, look, I'm just going to give it over to the Lord. I'm going to give it to my Lord. Jesus has a Lord? Yes, his Father. Jesus committed himself to him who judges righteously. Jesus gave over his own rights, his own even godliness, to his Father and left it there and didn't defend himself. So a lot of times people get this wrong impression about Jesus is going to come and be violent and everything else. And when he comes, simply at the battle of Armageddon, all he has to do is say, peace, be still, and boom, everybody's wiped out. That's simple. He didn't have to do any major cutting and shooting and whatever it is that people like to think that he's going to do, because Jesus would rather we learn the way of love, the way of peace, the way that would make us meek and lowly. Because meekness is not weakness. Meekness is the recognition that, wow, he's bigger than we are, so we ought to leave it up to him to do what we can't do for ourselves. And so don't get caught up into this power trip that we have in the West. but rather recognize that there's something that came from the East, which is the recognition that there's a greater authority than we have. Because notoriously, Western cultures like to assert themselves, where Eastern cultures will lift up others to be assertive for them. So, I hope that word from the Lord would be good for me, because at times I want to defend myself too. If any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. By honor and dishonor, by evil report and good report, all that will live godly in Christ Jesus will suffer persecution, the offense of the cross. If I yet pleased men, I should not be the servant of Christ. If you be reproached for the name of Jesus, happy are you. But let none of you suffer as a murderer, or as a thief, or as an evildoer, or as a busybody in other men's matters. Yet if any man suffer as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify God on this behalf. Unto you it is given in the behalf of Jesus to not only believe on him, but also to suffer for his sake. If one died for all, then we are all dead. And then he died for all, and that he died for all, but that we should live not henceforth unto ourselves, but unto him which died for us and rose again. If we suffer, we shall also reign with him. The issue isn't so much the question of whether we are persecuted, because anybody can create an environment of persecution, but rather, what are we doing with what God has given us and sharing with others about what God wants for them? And the reality is that Jesus came to save souls from hell. Jesus came to prevent the loss of human life in eternity to condemnation and judgment, when he wanted to bring salvation and relationship with his Father. How sad it is, and it should make us very meek and very humbled to think that we could participate with God in some way to reach out to souls that are in rebellion against God, that are heading for hell, and that in one simple way we could be the difference between whether a person chooses to go to heaven or to go to hell. All based upon sometimes the things we say, the way we do, and how we act when we walk with Jesus, when we talk with him, when we do those things he wants us to do, or we choose to do it our way.